Hello everyone, ex-Muslim and Free here. Today I want to explain why we should celebrate and be extremely happy that Islam is not true. Before I begin, I want you to think about something. Do you believe God is love? Do you think God loves humans and his creation? Is God even worth believing in if he does not love his creation? It is no secret that Islam is a religion based on fear, and being afraid is an integral part of Islam. On the screen you are going to see some of the many verses that explicitly command a believing Muslim to be afraid of either Allah or Hellfire. The reason being terrified was so important for Islam was because fear can make people very obedient, and Muhammad wanted to be obeyed. In fact, that was one of the main reasons he started his own religion. Men like control over other people, and you can either get it through fear or through respect. Fear usually works far better. For example, if you look at Iran today and the Revolutionary Guard loyal to the mullahs, what is the point of the Revolutionary Guards? Their purpose is to generate fear of the mullahs so the people are oppressed into obedience. Total control and obedience, something Muhammad clearly wanted from his followers, could only be gained if they were terrified of disobeying him. This is why Islam is so obsessed with being afraid, since disobeying any of Muhammad's orders would have landed you a quick ticket to death, because Muslims would have swiftly declared you an apostate, murdered you, and Muhammad's God would have gladly burned you in hell. Now I know Muslims will be saying that Islam doesn't teach you to be afraid of Muhammad, but God, Allah. This is true to some extent, but remember, Quran says that whoever obeys Muhammad obeys Allah. So in a sense, a Muslim cannot be a Muslim if he disobeys Muhammad. Furthermore, you must realize that Muhammad invented Allah. Therefore, being afraid of Allah meant that Muhammad could get whatever he wanted, because if Muhammad wanted something done, he released a verse in the Quran so the Muslims would think it's actually Allah asking them to do it, when it really is something Muhammad wants. It's a clever trick, a clever con. Allah says whatever Muhammad wants Allah to say. By being scared of Allah, Muslims would do whatever the Quran says, when it really is Muhammad putting it in the Quran. If Muhammad wanted to marry a 6-year-old girl when he was 50 and have sex with her when he was 53 and she was 9, suddenly Allah agreed and was okay with this. Muhammad wanted to marry more than 4 women because he wanted a lot more sex. Suddenly, Allah agreed and sent him a conveniently timed revelation that allowed him to do this. Don't tell me he married all these women because he needed to build alliances and loyalties. Why would a man who has God on his side need human alliances? Is it because Muhammad knew that the God he invented was not going to save him if he got into trouble? And how does marrying a 6-year-old girl and having sex with her when she is 9 help his cause? No, his marriage to Aisha was simply a lust for young flesh. Same with Safiya, who was a Jewish woman who Muhammad slept with when she was 17 and he was in his 50s. A lust for young flesh. In fact, Aisha, in this hadith on the screen that you can see, noticed and teased Muhammad that Allah suspiciously was very quick to give Muhammad whatever he wanted. Because she said, "I feel Allah is quick to please you." In And the Quran, it even says that Muhammad gets special privileges that no other Muslim does. This is proof that he was putting in the Quran whatever he wanted done. And he was using the idea of it being God to make sure that Muslims would do it without asking questions. The best way to get something is to say God wants you to have it. Additionally, as another example of this, if Muhammad wanted more time alone with his wives so he could have more sex with them, suddenly Allah released a verse telling people to leave his house as soon as they have eaten, because staying for long annoys Muhammad. You begin to wonder, why is a book that was supposed to be for mankind as a whole and had information useful for every part of the earth so obsessed with this one man and what that man wanted? The verse where it says Muhammad is allowed more than four wives, or that people should leave his house as soon as they have finished eating, are totally irrelevant today. They have no use and have no moral teaching in them. They are a relic that prove Muhammad was making up the Quran as he went along, putting in it things he wanted done, and Muslims thought that it was Allah really asking them. Allah said what Muhammad wanted Allah to say. It is nothing more than a clever con, and considering how illiterate the Arabs were, it was very easy to fool them. Now, why should we celebrate the fact that Islam is not true? Because if it was true, life would not be worth living. It would have been better to not have been born at all, or dying as a child, than to live through life in a world made by Allah. Since we would have been created by a God who can only be described as a tyrant looking for any excuse to torture you from the moment you start to think. There would be no privacy, no liberty, no freedom, and no hope. There is no hope offered in Islam. You're not even asked for your consent whether you want to be part of this pointless life. You are nothing more than a plaything, a toy that God can decide when to dispose of. The God of Islam is not only someone who doesn't love humans, he actively hates them. Any chance he can find, he seems desperately to be looking for in order so he can justify torturing you. Now, we all know that Islam has many contradictions as a religion. Some people say that anyone who believes the faith of Islam will go to heaven. Others say no, you must pray 5 times a day, every day till you die. Others say that to get heaven, you need to die in battle for Allah. The point is, life as a Muslim is full of worry, constant paranoia of whether you have offended this insecure deity called Allah, who seems to have no self-confidence and is easily offended, haunts the Muslim mind. Muslims say that life is a test, and the reward for passing this so-called test is heaven. But what kind of a test is it that the only real way for most people to pass is if they are lucky enough to be born into the winning team in the first place? If life is a test, then it is the most unfair, the most pointless, the most biased and meaningless test ever imaginable. What is the point? What does Allah get out of it at all? What about the billions of humans who have died or are living today without ever hearing about this pointless test? It seems that Allah really loves torturing and making people suffer, because not only has He created a test in which most people are doomed to failure to begin with, since they are born into a non-Muslim family, but just to doubly guarantee and make sure that people fail this test, Allah has allowed hundreds of religions and cults to flourish and gifted the world with Satan himself. Satan, who you cannot detect, who whispers into your ear without you knowing and can influence your behavior without you ever being aware of it, whose sole job it is to deceive you and do everything in his power from your birth till death to lead you into hell. That is a God-given gift for you. On top of all this pressure, Allah himself has done Satan's jobs for him by leading people to hell himself. For example, look at this verse in the Quran. Nor will he guide you, except towards the path of hell. He's proud of it. He's proud of leading people into hell and doing Satan's job for him. I say again, if life is a test, Allah has made sure to do everything possible to make us fail, and we should not be very impressed. He might as well not have created heaven at all, since most people aren't even going there. If anyone actually looked at Allah and tried to describe him in an honest manner, the only way they could accurately describe him is as follows. A demanding and heartless bully who is desperate for attention and wants humans to constantly beg him for forgiveness over insignificant things. Someone who judges harshly and, while calling himself the All-Merciful, doesn't show actual signs of mercy. Someone who creates homosexuality and then tortures homosexuals. Who creates sex itself and then tortures those who take part in this activity. Instead of creating a world in which humans can be happy and live a full, long, happy life, he gives us disease, animals that eat us, natural disasters, a planet with most of its area too cold or too hot, not enough fresh water, radiation, volcanoes, earthquakes, tsunamis, and he demands the impossible for us to love him and be terrified of him at the same time. It is a wonderful thing. It is a wonderful thing that Islam is not true. How horrible and worthless life would be if Islam was true. How humans should wish they had never existed if Allah truly was our creator. In fact, you can see it on the face of every true Muslim. They live a life of worry and fear and are always focused on the day they will die because they know that their God is a tyrant and impossible to please. Death petrifies them. Life as a Muslim is that of being afraid, and you live a life of misery till you die, not knowing whether or not you have passed this pointless and silly test. Every second a Muslim is busy asking for forgiveness from this impossible to please God for just being born. My brothers and sisters, Muslims, give this belief up and realize that it is a good thing that Islam is a lie and there is no hell. The reason Allah seems such a bully and a tyrant is because Muhammad wanted to create the illusion that his followers are always being watched, and if they decide to disobey Muhammad, Muhammad will instantly know, since Allah will tell him. Also, that disobeying Muhammad would have meant that the person will go to hell. This was a way for Muhammad to ensure there was no disobedience. Muhammad thus created a gang of followers that were completely petrified and under his command, would do whatever he asked. Muhammad got what he wished for, complete and total submission and obedience. The amount of fear is still detectable in Muslims. You do not need to live this life being petrified. Aren't you glad you can live your life in freedom and without worry? One of the best ways to control other people is to say that God has chosen you as their leader and wants you to lead them, and anyone who does not follow will be punished harshly. If Allah is real, you may ask, wouldn't it be better to just believe in him to avoid this punishment? Actually, if Allah was real, I would have this to say to him. Thanks for creating me, but no thanks, since you have given me the most horrible life imaginable with this childish test. Grow up, stop getting offended over silly things, and stop torturing human beings. Leave humans alone to get on with their lives and let us live in peace. I don't want your heaven because I won't feel comfortable enjoying myself selfishly while most humans who have ever lived are being tortured. I did not ask to be a part of your pointless test, so leave me alone. I hope you enjoyed my video and it made you think. Peace be upon to you, my brother and sister in humanity.